neighborhood to see if you can help. Step Up for India, the organization that I co-founded with Shanti Nair and Sangana Lakshmi, started from that very same impulse that all of us share. The impulse to lend a helping hand to someone in need. We started in 2013 with just 30 volunteers teaching English in 3 government schools in our neighborhood. And I'd like to share with you a little bit of what happens inside a classroom when our volunteers teach.
Theater, I left India
political science in the US. Luckily, despite the fact that I was doing a lot of extracurricular activities, I was a good student, and so I got a scholarship to Columbia University. And it was around this time that the weight of expectations felt heavy on my shoulders. I was told that I had got things too easily in life, and so I was very willing to give up things that others would have not dared to. And then there was this one incident when I was doing my PhD fieldwork that really shook me to my core. I was doing a survey across 17 districts of Maharashtra, trying to understand the underlying basis of identity politics. And I had just finished interviewing an old man who happened to be from the Mahar caste, which is the untouchable low caste in Maharashtra. And so I mentioned to him that I was studying in the same university that Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar studied in. And as you all know, Dr. Ambedkar is the father of our constitution and also the foremost fighters against the oppressive caste system in India. And when he heard this, the old man just got up and reached out to touch my feet. He was so overcome with emotion at having met someone who had studied in the same institution that his beloved leader had. And then he proceeded to tell me how his community continued to face the problems and asked me what I could do to help. During my survey over the 2 months in Maharashtra, I met with a lot of men and women, young and old, and many of them asked for help, asked for advice, asked for jobs in the cities. The weight of expectations was overwhelming. And then I did my PhD. I started teaching in University of California, Irvine. And a few years later, we moved back to India. And this is where I encountered another mental prison of my own making. Ever since my fieldwork, I had felt moved to work on the ground, to work with the people, to work in the field of education, because I had come to see education as the primary driver of change. But I held myself back. I had begun to define myself by my resume. I had begun to define my present and my future by my past, by what I was good at, by what I was trained to do. I was trained to be a researcher. I had a degree in political science. I had taught at the university level. So I told myself that these aspects had to be a part of what I did in India. And as a compromise between what I felt moved to do and what I was trained to do, I joined an organization that worked in the area of civic participation and urban planning. I was heading research there, and I was working on a lot of government committees as a representative of the organization. But it was important work, but my heart was not in it. So I began studying, I began reading scholarly works on education. But I really wanted to go on the ground and see, experience for myself what it was like in a government school. And so I decided to volunteer in the neighborhood government schools. And when I went there, I was working within the same framework of my resume. I offered to help teach a program in drama or help create a curriculum to teach the older students social research skills in the government schools. And the principals flatly refused. All they really desperately sought from volunteers like me was to teach their children English. So, I was given this fifth standard textbook, and I was asked to teach this. this chapter to a classroom full of bright, eager faces. And I stood there, but I didn't know how to proceed, because the majority of the students in my class could not read three-letter words like cat, red, sun. And studies show that over 50% of the students in fifth standard nationwide cannot read these simple three-letter words. So there was a real need for English teachers in government schools. And I noticed that there were a lot of English-speaking volunteers in our neighborhood who were willing to spend a few hours a month to teach. So all that was really required was a program that was easy, enjoyable, and effective, and that enabled these volunteers to work as a team and seamlessly teach English to these government school students. Around that time, there was a local charitable organization that asked me if I wanted to lead a project in a local school. And impulsively, I just thought of the kids that I had taught in my English class. And I said, I'd do an English program. And the moment I said that, I began to question myself. Because I was not an expert English teacher. I had never created an English program. So what was I signing up to do? But when I commit to doing something, I give it everything I've got. And soon, Shanti and Sangana joined me to form Step Up for India. Now, they were as passionate about education as I was, but they were not experts in English either. Shanti worked as a financial analyst in the UK for 18 years, and Sangana worked in the Bay Area in the software industry. Had we defined ourselves by our resume, we would not have dared to even start. But we started on a shoestring budget and very stringent deadlines, and we probably because we were not experts, put in a lot of effort to really understand the problem and try to solve it. But it was all a lot of fun, and it was and continues to be extremely fulfilling. So along the way, we did have to learn a lot of new skills, but unexpectedly, a lot of our dormant talents like singing and data analysis and painting and drama, all of these came into play, and we ended up creating a program that is now, we are working with the government to take across the state. So, unfortunately, a lot of us very early on start defining ourselves by our resume. We pigeonhole ourselves. We define what we are capable of based on whether or not we get selected for certain activities in our school, or whether or not we get good marks in a certain subject, in a certain exam, or whether we get into a program or a certain university. What my journey has taught me is that our brain power and our talents are not fixed entities. We are all capable of learning and growing throughout our lives. And if we see ourselves as lifelong learners, and if we are willing to put in the hard work to prepare ourselves to face the challenges, we can achieve almost anything we really want. So, what advice would I give my younger self? I'd say when something moves you to act, don't ask what your one true passion is. Don't get immobilized by the weight of expectations. Don't define yourself by your resume. Listen to that nagging voice in your heart. Take a chance and step up and do it. But be willing to learn. Be willing to put in the hard work. And I'd say, try not to worry, because it all works out for the best. Now, today we were asked to talk about Parivartan Shakti, the power to change society. So you might be wondering, what am I saying? What should you be doing to bring about change in society? What does the world need you to do? share with you a quote that I have come to